All right, that was very fresh. I want to ask Junjun first. Did that have to happen?
No, I was really keeping my cool. She was that Karen, on her way back to the chair, talagang nanlilisip yung mata niya. Tapos, may kita niya naman dun sa video eh. Contrary to what she's saying na nagsasalita ako, you can play that video over and over again. In fact, I was just looking in front. Siya ito yung talagang sinisigawan niya ako, dinuduro niya ako doon. I even tried to pacify her. Kasi nakakaya, you know, it's very embarrassing, di ba, na magtatalo kami. But, you know, I could have been a better person on hindsight. Pero okay. Tao lang tayo, Karen, na hindi ko na rin natiis eh. Dahil, biro mo, dinuduro-duro ka. Siyempre, yung natural reactions, you have to defend yourself. Yeah, kumbaga, I was past the point na yung pacifying. Kasi ayaw niyang tumigil. Hanggang tumayo na ako, sinisigawan pa rin ako nung kapatid ko.
Now, of course, all our viewers are not Makati residents. Okay. So they were not there at the PPCRV-sponsored debate. I would assume that the debate wanted to tackle really issues of service in Makati. Mm-hmm. Was that tackled at all?
Well, what happened there, Karen, is that you... There's a fishbowl,
yeah.
And then you choose a question,
uh-oh.
And then you answer it.
Okay.
And then we were actually towards the end of the program, where you just say your platform. Ginawa ng sister ko, tinitira niya ako na bawal na daw ang 15:30 sa City Hall. Di inisip ko...
Casual? Ibig sabihin nun casual, 15:30? Or
no, yung every 15 and 30 lang papasok, hindi
okay.
Nagtatrabaho. So inisip ko, Karen, sasagutin ko ba to? Kasi... Sinasabi niya, galit siya sa 15:30. Pero may nahuli kami na City Hall employee na oras ng trabaho na mimigay ng black propaganda dito sa District 2 ng Makati. City Hall employee at oras ng trabaho. So sabi ko, wag na lang, hindi ko na lang papatulan. And then sinasabi niya, madami daw ghost employees.
But knowing... Noong time mo, yun ang claim, no?
Wala naman siyang nakasuhan. Wala siya, I mean, 3 years na Karen. Noong una, wala siyang sinasabing ganyan. And now, because of this election, sinasabi niya, maraming mga ghost employees. And yet, sino ngayon yung nakasuhan niya? You know, it's more on really yung mga PR releases na meron siyang galit sa mga 1530,
okay.
Ghost employees, and
now,
all of that.
Your father, it came to a point that your father, former Vice President Jejomar Binay, which I can imagine must be so painful for him, he's in his 70s, had to intervene. Were you still there, Nancy?
Actually, I was there, but sabi ko, tapos na to. So umalis na kami together with my mom and my other sister.
Yeah.
Umalis na kami. So hindi na natin naabutan yung
kaguluhan. When your dad stood up.
Yeah, we didn't
okay,
see that.
What anymore. Did your father say?
He just wanted to separate us. Kasi it was very apparent that emotions were very high. So
was that the only time? Because the one we showed on the video was you were giving a speech and your father stood up. He was beside Abby. He stood up and he tapped you. Parang in effect saying, parang anak tama na.
Okay.
Yun lang ba yun?
So, kasi she gave her parang closing.
Uh-oh.
Dapat platform, but all she did was hit on
you.
Whoever, not okay. Me. Nagpasaring lang siya or anything. So, baka, anyways. So, ayoko na siyang patulan. And then, that regrettable incident happened.
Which is?
Yung nagkasagutan na kami.
Uh-oh.
Okay? And then, it was my turn to give my speech. So, sabi nung organizer,
do you still nagkasagutan kayo, nakaupo kayong dalawa, magkatabi.
Actually, pabalik siya eh.
Oh, can we show that?
Yeah.
I mean, ito yung alatang nag-aaway kayo.
Well, makikita nyo, sisigawan niya ako.
Yeah, go on, yeah. So you were saying.
Medyo nagsettle ng konti. And the organizers asked if I wanted to continue because it was my turn now to say my platform.
Oo.
So,
yeah.
So they gave me the mic.
Yeah.
And then nagsalita na ako.
Okay.
And then you'll see a video of
now, Senator Nancy, you are the eldest. Okay, that's the video we're showing now. We're in your seated beside each other, no? And here you are, you're arguing clearly on television, right? So what were you arguing about?
Okay. So on her way back,
uh-oh.
So pinangdidilata niya ako.
That moment.
And then sinabi niya, yeah. Ayan, sasabi niya. Kasi she was so fired up when she was giving her speech.
Yes.
And then when she sat down, makikita mo, galit na galit siya eh. Talaga, ang laki ng mata niya. And then sabi niya, sinungaling ka, sinasabi mo na nagda-drug si Luis.
And then you'll see there na ituturo niya yung cameraman ng ABS.
Oo.
Sabi ko, Ate Ab, wala akong sinabi dito na nagda-drugs yung asawa mo. Hindi, sinungaling ka, sinabi mo na nakuha na ng ABS na sinabi mo yun. Sabi ko, wala akong, and yun na, doon na, sigaw na siya ng sigaw. So, hindi ko na rin siya maawat.
Oo. Okay, so, as the eldest, Nancy, how do you deal with your two siblings? I mean, Abby is next to you, and then you have Junjun after, right? What is your role?
Well, yung incident no Saturday, in fact, after that brouhaha, they went to my house, and then medyo pinagsabihan ko nga siya. Sabi ko, you know, there's no explanation that would make that incident correct. Pareho kayong talo dyan. Pangit. Sana hindi nangyari. But you know, naiintindihan ko naman yung posisyon niya na tao lang naman siya na nasasaktan din. And I know the history na kinikim-kim niya. Ang dami niya nang pinalipas. Kaya hindi ko rin naman siya masisi. But sana hindi na nga nangyari yung ganun. Dahil pangit talaga eh.
Oo.
Sabi ko nga, you know, si Ab has been here.
Yes, twice.
Twice
yes,
already.
Yes, yes. During the campaign. So the campaign, the filing, Abby and then Junjun.
Yes.
And then just recently, maybe 2 weeks ago.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Then,
yeah. Yes. And you know, ako, as much as possible, I don't want to talk about our private life, what we've been going through the past years. But she's been talking about it. And I realized na parang, I think I have to say naman our side.
Yes,
kasi,
okay.
Diba, number one, siguro,
go ahead.
I'll do the several points that she raised during her interview. Number one, she said, hindi kami close dahil nag-aral siya sa UP Las Banas. That's not true. Kahit na nag-aaral pa siya sa UPLB, close kami, lalo na kaming mga girls. Kasi kami yung laging nag-vacation with my mom.
Yeah.
Kami yung may time to be together because my dad was, well, silang dalawa,
yeah, yeah.
They were both working.
Uh-oh.
So kami talaga yung laging magkakasamang, kami mga babae. So hindi totoo yun na it was because nag-aral siya sa Las Banas, kaya hindi kami close.
Yeah, yeah.
Our personal rift all started when she started dating yung asawa niya ngayon.
Okay.
Parang sabi ko nga, ano yung pinag-awayan nila last Saturday? Siya pa din.
Si Luis.
Siya pa din yung,
wow.
Siya pa din yung reason, di ba? So, that started the rift because I've been hearing not so nice things about him when they were dating. So as a sister, I want the best for my sisters. I'm the eldest, katulad ng sinabi mo. I think minasama niya yon na kaming mga kapatid niya, even my mom, parang pinagsabihan siya na mag-ingat ka or parang ganon, to that effect, diba? So minasama niya yon. After that, hindi na niya kami kinausap.
But you guys
kinausap.
Didn't go to the wedding?
No, we did.
Oh, you did? Okay,
we did.
Okay.
No, when they were still dating.
Okay.
So parang,
so feeling mo nag-start doon?
Hindi na niya kami kinausap.
Okay.
Because of that.
Okay.
Kasi feeling niya, siguro na pinakikialaman namin siya,
yes,
ayaw
yes.
namin dun sa boyfriend niya then. But you know, natanggap naman namin na mahal niya. Na
because you went to the wedding, ah.
We I went mean, to the wedding.
You have
and
Sunday
then,
lunches.
We've had Sunday lunches. Ay, what can we do? Yun yung gusto ng kapatid mo, di ba? We tried accepting him. We were civil to him. Hindi naman namin siya binabastos pag magkakaharap kami. Dahil hindi naman kami pinalaking bastos ng mga magulang namin. But, nagsimula yan na Sunday lunch, hindi na sila
pumupunta.
Well, sister ko lang na pumupunta, hindi na siya sumasama. And then eventually, hindi na sila pumupuntang mag-asawa. Noong 2016, after 2016, noong naging mayor at congressman na silang dalawa, they don't attend our Sunday lunches.
Oo.
Which is harder for us to mend things. Kasi
okay.
Di ba, parang hindi na kami nakikita na parang ang feeling ko nga, kumbaga parang ano yan eh, connecting rooms.
Yeah, yeah.
Yung side nila, kinandado na nila yung kwarto.
Oo.
Samantalang kami, we're always there. We're still, well, I mean, for me, I'm still there for her.
But why didn't you support Abby for her re-election? I think her, just to annoy, she said that, you know, I asked Junjun, patapusin mo naman ako.
Siguro,
right? Go on.
Ihiwalay natin yung personal away namin dun sa pag-support ko sa kanya.
Okay.
You know, I've had issues then with my other sister. But kahit may issue kami, we're always there pag Sunday. Kasi yun na lang yung kaligayahan ng magulang namin na makita kami magkakasama every Sunday. I think she raised that issue dun sa calendar namin for this year na she was not there.
Yes.
And then she said, kasi daw, isipin mo, cause of stress niya kami. Diba? Parang kaming kapamilya niya.
Maybe pain. Maybe that's stress and pain.
Sabi niya, stress. Okay, during the interview, she said, kasi that photo was taken October.
Yeah.
Kasi nagpaparamdam na daw si Junjun na tatakbo siya. Na parang, of course, at sayo ko nga, ang alam lang niyang pagtakbo during the time, 10K, kasi he was busy preparing.
And this was the Christmas photo.
Yeah, noong 2017. Yes. That Christmas photo, di ba? That was taken 2017.
Tapos nilabas last year.
Yeah, because I'm the one who trabaho ko sa family and ako namimili na kung anong picture namin for the calendar. So noong 2017, since hindi siya nagpakita, had no choice but to release a photo na hindi kami kasama magkakapatid. Apo lang for that year. Unlike, usually every year kaming pamilya magkakasama doon.
Okay.
Kasi if nirelease ko that time 2017. Na 2017 na wala siya, that will already trigger na sandali, parang may problema yung pamilya dahil bakit wala siya.
Actually, Karen, pinuntan pa siya ng dad ko sa house niya to be part of that
photo,
that family photo.
So pinadala na lang niya yung anak niya.
So hindi pa rin siya pumunta. So even my dad reached out to her that time. It was October, hindi December yung photo because you released the
October kami usually.
Okay. Well, we just have an hour for the show,
that's the personal side. Politics aside, yung decision ko to support him is not affected by our personal rift.
But do you think so?
Because I helped her when she was running noong 2016. Kahit hindi, kahit ganun yung pagtrato niya sa akin, kahit ganun yung pagtrato niya sa amin na kapatid niya, all out. You know, nung tumatakbo siya, nag-house to house ako sa kanya. Kahit galito siya sa akin, umiikot ako for her. So, hindi porket may away kami, kaya ako hindi siya sinusuportan. Pinili ko siya, kasi nakikita ko dun sa baba, hindi niya tinuloy yung serbisyo na kilala yung pangalan namin. I am proud to say that I won because of my dad, because of the Binay name. Nung unang takbo ko, yun lang naman ang claim to fame ko talaga na people expected me to deliver the same kind of service that my dad wants. Oh,
did you talk to Abby and say, Abby, I mean, let's support Junjun. You run
she doesn't
for Congress.
Talk to us. Okay. You know, we've had several meetings with our parents kasi nga we're finding a win-win solution for that. Ako lalong-lalo na ako. I think she already mentioned na dapat may agreement na magba-back out si Junjun or magba-vice mayor na lang.
No, she said that,
Then hindi siya sumunod dun sa usapan.
No, parang the husband, the agreement was, if the husband chooses not to run, Junjun will also back out.
Yes, that was my suggestion.
Oh, but then she claims si Luis said, I will back out.
That's not true. I was the proponent of that suggestion. I brokered that win-win scenario because unang-una, natatakot ako for him. Kasi baka sakta nila si Junjun pag nag-away.
But why would they do that?
Because alam ko yung kapatid ko hindi niya kaya, pero may mga nakapaligid sa kanya kaya. So talaga fear ko, I was really fearing for his life. Una-una yung mga pamangkin ko, kawawa naman, wala na nga nanay, baka mawalan pa ng tatay kasi nga ganun ka, magiging ganun kainit pag naglaban sila. So I brokered that deal, sabi ko, pumayag na si Junjun, di siya tatakbo for mayor basta si Luis mag-back out.
Is that true?
Actually, Karen, kasi yung last year, I was already receiving information na there were people who were planning to hurt me. And I just told my mom kasi ayaw ko nang palakahin eh.
But the people planning to hurt you were from whose side?
I'd rather not say where it's coming from.
Uh-oh.
But I told my mom and my mom knows the whole story. They were actually, you know, getting my schedule. There was a person checking on me practically the whole day, yung mga activities ko, and I told my mom and my mom feared for my safety.
Yeah,
but I go around without.
You
without
don't think Luis and Abby are behind that?
I'd rather not comment at this point. Okay, but again, keeping it within the family, Karen, at least I had the opportunity to tell my mom and my sisters about it.
Wow. Okay. Now,
and so, then of course, Monette died.
Yeah.
My assistant died.
Yeah. But Abby told me, I mean, after the interview, that what hurts her is that they are accused, that, I mean, there are insinuations that they are behind the death killing of your...
But siguro ko, tutuloy ko lang yung...
Of your secretary,
that proposition, di ba? So, I kept on following up. Kung ano na ba, agreeable na ba kayo? And then, wala silang sagot. Until that time, tumalo na lahat kay...
Yung counselors.
So, parang, you know, and then, nung tumalo na, dun lang sila nagbigay na parang, okay, we're agreeing to your proposition. But, during that time, tumaya na yung mga tao sa kanya. So, I mean,
One month, Karen.
Deal is off already. Kahit gusto namin, eh, tumaya na, may mga tao na nag-out in the open. And, medyo may pagka-vindictive kasi that side. So, hindi naman pwedeng iwanan yung sumuporta na sa amin.
I'm curious, why do you think did the counselors support Junjun?
Para self-serving naman siguro.
I won't ask him. I'll ask you. Is it 80% of the council?
13 of the 16 elected.
Oh, that's like 80%, right? 13 of the 16 elected counselors jump ship. For why do you think?
Well, siguro tingin ko yung service or the way he leads baka mas acceptable sa kanila than my sister, because kaya nga yung Binay brand of service parang mas yung brother ko yung magko-continue than her.
Okay.
And plus, kaya hindi naman sumuporta yung mga yon sa kanya during the 2016, thinking na she will continue that kind of service, that kind of leadership.
Okay.
But she did not.
What is that kind of leadership? I mean, Abby was here, I'll ask you, and she said, Karen, the Binay brand is only my father can do that. What she said is she wants to, in a way, do a style wherein times have changed, modern na. It doesn't mean she doesn't serve, pero it's an ever-changing modern period, so to speak, no? So she talked about Wi-Fi. Yes, hindi siya pumupunta sa patay, pero marami siyang ibang tulong na ginagawa. Streamlining business. You know, these are the things Abby spoke of.
Okay.
Okay, let's just stick with that quickly that it's your platform.
Okay. So, Karen, it's not true that there's free Wi-Fi service in the entire city. There's no subway construction going on. She'll only mention shoes, boots, raincoats. So yun lang yung basically nagawa. But kung sasabihin niya na hindi pwede namin kunin yung brand of service na ginawa ng father ko, then I beg to disagree. Because kami ni Ate Nance, we continue that Binay kind of service.
What is the Binay kind of service? In Makati, clarify.
Karen. So we go down, we talk to the people, we have to be one with them.
Uh-oh.
Sabi nga ng Santo Papa, kailangan yung mga pare.
And she does not go down.
Well, how can you tend to your flock if you're not there, 'di ba? Kailangan kasama mo sila. Kailangan nga kung yung tamang paglilingkod, kailangan kaamoy mo yung tupa na pinapastol mo.
Now, sinabi rin ni Abby, and I want to ask your opinion on this, is she also wants to, of course, what she said is clean. The Binay name, after what your father's been through in the Senate, that Senate investigation, after your case with the Makati City Hall, I mean, na-dismiss, no? Am I right?
Yung sa Court of Appeals, yes.
Na-dismiss sa Court of Appeals. So, ang gusto rin ni Abby, she said on the show, is to give the Binay name in Makati like a fresh start, so to speak. To clean it, give her time to finish it, and then you could run after, first focus on your kids. I want to ask you, what's wrong with that, Junjun?
Well, first of all, hindi namin pwedeng tanggapin na tama yung mga final na kaso against me and my father. Because that was clearly politically motivated. Nanalo na nga tayo dun sa isang kaso. Nakita natin, ang fatherhood namin, number one, bago ho inatake ng mga kalaban namin sa politika. Kaya nga, may na-dismiss na tayo na kaso. Meron bang na-convict? Wala. Kasi alam naman natin, Ginawa lang yon dahil kasi gusto nilang siraan ang tatay ko. At syempre, dun sa pagsira na yon, nakasama ako dito dahil kasi, I'll take a bullet for my father. I'll defend my father and the entire family.
And you were okay. A mayor. I mean, you were the mayor.
Because
then.
It was the right thing to do. Wala, Karen, in fact, yung sinasabing mga kaso, walang napakitang ebidensya dun sa kaso na yan. And on the basis on that alone, nakikita ko na pwede nang matapos agad itong mga kaso na ito. Kasi walang napipresent. Eh.
Aren't you happy or satisfied with Abby's performance? What will change in Makati if you win over her?
There is a...
Isipin mo to the viewer. They're looking at it this way. Eh, pinalitan nga, Binay pa rin naman eh. Binay, yun naman, hindi naman iba ang papalit.
Karen, it's a leadership issue eh. I mean, if you have 13 of the 16 councilors leaving you, and more than 20 of the 33 barangay officials, may problema tayo eh. You know, I can mention several awards to you. Like, even the ombudsman awarded me on yung dun sa anti-red tape, doon sa ease of doing business. Again, noong 2014, Makati was number one as the most competitive, highly urbanized city in the country. Now we're only number six. O anong issue dyan? Dynamism, infrastructure, and then yung computerization program. Yan yung mga poste nitong competitiveness. Oh, if we say that we are performing, then why is the NCC saying otherwise? Tinalo kami ng Quezon City, Manila, Cagayan de Oro, Davao City, even Pasay City. Number six na lang ang Makati.
Okay. Now, Nancy, what happens after the elections? I mean, you had Abby saying also, of course, she was crying and saying, basta we'll try and fix everything after. Because so many painful things have been said.
Sa akin, on our, uh-oh, I'll speak for yeah, our side.
Yeah.
But never hindi, naman kami nagsara ng pinto sa kanya.
Hindi ka pa, can you forgive her?
Oh, there's nothing to forgive.
Oh, you're
magkakapatid not... kami. Diba? Sa akin nga, the door is always open for her. Unlike her, mukhang sinusian na niya. Sabi ko nga, ang pag-ibig, hindi lang nakakapuwing, minsan nakakabulag.
So you think it's her love for Luis?
That's... Mukha. Uh-oh. But going back dun sa cleaning, you know,
the name.
Diba? Cleaning the name does not mean changing the brand of service. Hindi namin dapat erase yung Binay service na sinimula ng dad ko because yun yung ginagawa niya sa baba ngayon I'll cite lang, I'll have a photo. Kasi kami ni Junjun, meron kami yearly tradition na pumupunta kami sa ospital ng Makati.
Okay.
That is a legacy of my father. When I go around the Philippines, yun yung lagi nilang sinasabi na yung ospital ng Makati, ganyan-ganyan. Ito ngayon ang ospital ng Makati namin ngayon, yung sabitan ng kortina, naging sabitan ng dextrose. This is not the Binay brand of service.
I see.
Diba? Parang... Uh-oh. Nakita mo naman.
Bago to, this is a new one.
This is December.
So what you're saying is, it deteriorated by the service in Makati, deteriorated when Abby took over?
Well, unang-una yung healthcare program. Yung Makati is known for that. That's a program started by my dad when he was the mayor. Yeah. Tinuloy ng mom ko, tinuloy niya. Tapos ngayon, ganito na yung itsura, di ba?
Ito Karen, namamatay sa sahig na lang.
Okay, can we show
this,
that?
Di ba, parang so, hindi to ospital sa premier city of the Philippines.
I see. So, kumbaga, you really have major issues on her leadership.
Yes, this has nothing to do with our personal issues. This is, for me, yung service that our Makati residents deserve.
Okay, but how will your family heal? When, of course, outrightly, I mean, it's so hard to be in politics. Parang I'm imagining if it were me and my sister or brother. When you need to criticize a sibling in public to make a point, diba? To make this point wherein it's not personal, but that would still hurt her.
Well, we're just hoping na we'll move past that.
Okay.
Yung mga...
You're hoping may the best man win, but you're hoping to move past it.
Of course. Sabi ko nga, yung election will end May 13. After that, the healing process must
Okay. Begin.
Begin.
Tanong ko, if Abby wins Junjun, will you support her?
Oo naman.
You will?
Oo naman. Uh-oh. Just like I've supported my sister throughout her entire political career. She ran for Congress. I was there. She ran for mayor. I supported my sister.
No, so let's say hypothetically she wins. Anong gagawin mo? Will you call her? Will you go and say, Abby, congratulations?
Karen, put it this way. Nung start ng campaign, sabi nung sister ko, kahit matapos tong election na to, hindi na kami magkakayos-ayos. Yeah, yeah. But when she went here, she said, then there's hope, di ba, na maayos. So ang ganda naman nung gesture din na yun. Yeah. So kami naman, kami magkakapatid, and speak for the entire family on this one, ate. Laging bukas ang pintuan namin para makaayos-ayos yung pamilya because it's one family at the end of the day.
Oh, pero if you win, do you think she would support you?
Well, I'm hoping that she will. I'm hoping, I hope that she will go beyond her character of may tendency to be vindictive talaga. Yun yung character niya. So, I'm praying that with her kind gesture of saying that she's open to fix things after the election, eh sana nga mangyari yun.
Okay. We'll go to Nancy first. You're doing very well in the surveys as the senatorial race, no? I mean, at one point, you were even hitting number 3. So you generally move from a 1 to 5 or 6 level where you have experts already saying a 1 to 6 is safe. I mean, more or less, it's very hard to put them back down. What are your thoughts on that?
Ako, for me kasi, what's important is the result on election day. Okay. Sa akin, ang survey is just a tool for me to know where to campaign, where to go.
But where to go.
Para maging basis ko yan na panalo ko, hindi ganun ang tingin ko sa survey. So until now, I still have to go out, I still have to campaign.
Because, okay.
Based on the 2013 results, meron dun sa survey, like Grace yeah, yeah. was a month before election day, she was number 10, but you know, she ended up number one. And then Senator Villar was, I think, 3 to 5.
Mataas naman.
And JV then, mataas din. They ended up 10-11.
So kumbaga, you can't predict.
No.
Pero one thing that's quite interesting with you, because I've interviewed you before, and I realized that, you know, hindi ka nagtatanim. I mean, hindi ka generally talaga pikon or nagtatanim.
Hindi.
The fact that Senator Trillanes approached you in the Senate, I mean, he did head a 1-year campaign against your dad of investigating him every day for a year in the Senate. He went up to you, and I remember kinwento mo dito yon, and napatawad mo si Senator Trillanes. And even the bashers that used to make fun of your color, di ba, na Binay, maitim, may libro ka pa.
Yes.
Gumawa ka pang libro tungkol doon. Where do you get that quality? Siguro, can you share?
Baka it's the way I was raised by my parents. Or baka sa pagiging panganay ko, kailangan, I have to be the calm and level-headed. Kasi di ba, I mean, how would I pacify things kung ako pa yung manggagatong sa brother ko na sige, maghalit ka pa ng maghalit.
Pero you are also taking your own stand. I mean, you recently came out with a statement on illegal Chinese workers. You were very firm among all the candidates running.
Well, 2 yan, illegal Chinese workers and even legal Chinese workers. Because alam mo ba, Karen, we've been issuing work permits for construction workers.
Yeah.
Which I think is not acceptable because we have enough supply of Filipino construction workers, na world class. So why do we need to get foreign nationals for that kind of job?
So who is Senator Nancy Binay as a senator?
Ako, as
are you taking your own, making your own brand in the national, you know?
Still the same brand. Okay. It's still the same Binay service that my father started. At the end of the day, what will be good for the people, yun yung laging dapat mindset, di ba? Parang hindi ako, it's not about your party affiliations, it's about what will be good for the people.
Okay, back to local, forgive me for this question from one of the viewers. How did Congressman Monsur Del Rosario, who was allied with Abby and Luis, end up being Junjun's running mate? Okay, so Monsur Del Rosario is your right. How did that happen?
But first of all, si Monsur, he ran under my ticket. when okay. I ran for mayor.
All right. Actually, this viewer, I wasn't able to ask before, also ask Abby if she hates Monsor, because Karen, she does. Okay? go, you can answer that. I just won't.
Pwede ako na lang.
Oh, yes, go.
Kasi we're going back na naman to my brother-in-law.
Oh, it's really okay.
Kasi they were together sa Congress. Okay. They were part of the minority bloc. So nag-away silang dalawa.
So Luis and Monsor quarreled in Congress.
Yeah, ito sa... Medyo.
Actually, they were very close. Kasi
magkatabi
they were
sila.
Together in the 2016 election and they oh. both won. And then in this incident, si Luis yeah. asked Monsur to get him coffee and water. So, dun na nag-start yung ano. And then, of course, si Luis, nagsasalita rin siya in Congress and nakakarating din sa family namin na yeah. sinasabi niya, tapos na yung mga Binay, panahon na ng campus ngayon.
Oh, so, or may sinasabi pa siya na mas gaganda daw ang Makati pag campus na.
So,
that reached your father.
Yes.
But
yes.
why did your father still support Abby? I think yan ang tanong. Diba? Go on.
Well,
I mean, considering that you're saying Luis is clearly a major thorn, so to speak, you had former Vice President Binay still supporting Abby. Why?
Well, you know, we can't speak
for him,
right? But ako naman, ano bang tawag doon?
Siguro, well, si Luis hindi binigyan ng kona from my father's party.
That's true. Una, wala. Wala. Wala siya sa una.
Wala siya yeah. sa una.
Oo, that's one.
Siguro kasi sa akin, I think my sister said, siya yung pinili kasi he was being the...
Father of Makati.
Yeah, more than our father. Sa akin naman, he was being more of a father. Kasi nga, alam niya na dun sa family dynamics namin, halos lahat kami is with my Junjun. Brother. So, pag nawalan pa siya ng isang family member on her side, baka we might totally lose her already.
So, you think that's the reason?
Baka.
How is your mother? Abby said, well, your mother tries to be fair, operative word being... tries. No, I mean, where does she stand in all this?
Well, as much as possible. Ayaw na niya, you've never seen her go
yes.
up my brother's stage. She tries talaga to be neutral because at the end of the day, mommy namin siya. Pare-pareho, di ba?
Yeah. Does this still hurt you, Nancy? I mean, you seem quite calm and strong, but I can see the pain when you talk about...
Ako more of hurt for my parents. Kasi I am also a parent and I don't want to be on their shoes right now. Kaya nga kung ako, sana hindi na lang namin pinapili yung mga magulang namin kung saan sila lulugar, diba? But nandito na tayo ngayon eh.
What about you, Junjun? No? I mean, Abby made a point that you have four kids. I mean, your wife tragically passed away. Wouldn't you want this time to also first take care of your four kids? Why go back to politics right away?
Because there's something more important than me at this point. People are craving for the better service that they really deserve. Yung kaninang pinakitang picture. How can you stand to look at that, Karen? You know, we had a world-class hospital, and now people are going there and they're dying on the ground, di ba? Nandun na lang sa sahig. Wheelchairs, na senior citizens, naka-wheelchair. How can you accept that?
So parang sinisira ba? Mas napapalala ba yung Binay service brand with Abby? Is that what you're saying?
Well, for me, malaking issue yung ayaw niyang sundan kung ano yung nasimulan ng father ko. Because that basically tells us that she's not pursuing the excellence for health, public health, yung excellence for education, okay? Infrastructure, okay? Ang dami natin pwedeng sabihin, pero kailangan maramdaman natin that they're actually being done. Ang problema is pwedeng maraming sasabihin, pero wala naman din talagang nangyayari.
Okay. We don't have enough time left, but I want to ask you both. I'll start with you, Junjun. For sure, Abby is watching this right now, or okay. she will definitely get to see it. What would you like to tell her? I mean, when we opened the show, you said, in hindsight, Karen, I wish I didn't have to do that, diba? Okay. What would you want to tell her now that it's the day after, you know, you're calmer, medyo things have settled.
Well,
let me, to Abby.
Okay. Ito na lang, Karen, because nung una nagsalita yung father ko, sinabi niya na bahala na yung mga taga Makati pumili sa amin dalawa. And sabi niya na dapat ang eleksyon, papakita namin sa buong Pilipinas na ito ay magiging tungkol sa issue lamang at hindi personalan. Kami, ever since, lagi kaming nakakatig doon sa issue ng plataforma. But somehow, laging nasa-segue yung issue papunta doon sa mister niya. Ang feeling niya lagi, ang ina-atake, yung asawa niya. So, ang nangyayari, it becomes personal for her.
Okay.
Diba? When we talk about drugs, iniisip niya agad yung sinasabihan namin ng issue ng drugs, yung asawa niya. Diba? So may mga ganun eh. So, ako, ang pakiusap ko, kami, ang sinasabi namin ay laging patungkol lang dun sa kung ano ang gusto namin gawin. At, Ate Abby, hindi ko ginagawa na saktan ka o ang pamilya mo.
But why did you say she was running out of vengeance?
Because yung ginagawa ngayon niya is, tinan mo, Karen, bakit kailangan niyang gawin na may nahuli pa kami na empleyado ng... Ito yung empleyado ng City Hall. Ito ang mga naninira. Paano ngayon na magiging platforma ang issue ngayon natin? Kinasuhan namin ito eh. Bir mo oras ng trabaho, ito ang ginagawa.
Okay.
So ako Ate Ab, kung platforma lang. Kung ang pakiramdam mo nagiging personal itong election na ito, eh hindi ko intention yan.
Okay, all right. What about you?
Sa akin,
Nancy, what's your message to
Simple lang, you know, pag wala na kami sa pwesto, yeah. You know, at the end of the day, yung mga nakapaligid sa amin, marami sa mga nakapaligid sa amin, mawawala lahat yan. Pero kami yung pamilya niya will always be there for her. Yeah. Kahit ginaganyan niya kami pa rin yung kadugo niya. Kaya kahit ang daming nabato, we're still family.
Yeah. Do you think she's forgotten that?
I think so. Kasi yung tagal na niya, you know, yung sa mga magulang namin, I can see the pain kasi hindi na nila kami nakikita na buo. Hindi nila kami nakikita magkasama. So as a parent, I can feel yung pinagdadaanan nila ngayon. And you know, they're not young. Sana yung mga remaining years nila, magtulungan kami magkakapatid to make it happy for them.
Personally, ano na yung request mo kay Abby?
Request? Sana...
Parang kung kausap mo siya ngayon, what do you wanna say to Abby?
Yun nga eh, they're both running, 2 weeks na lang. Let's stick to the platforms and yung kung ano yung magagawa and let's stop, this is not about us, no. Yung personal away namin.
Wala ka ba dyan, Abby, I still love you?
Ay, parang diyan kami gano'n.
But you do.
Of course, no, she's my sister. I will always be her ate. Diba? Nagsimula naman to lahat kasi nagiging ate ako sa kanya.
All right. On that note, Senator Nancy Binay, thank you so much for coming to the show. Junjun, thank you so much for coming.